Hey folks, welcome back to Deadly Premonition. Let me organize my crap here. Okay, there we go. Okay, so last time we had to go to Becky's house. Shit got real. And it would have worked out more or less okay, I think, except George kind of screwed the pooch and tried to cut Becky down, and some kind of Gordian knot of horrible sharp wire basically snapped her neck, strangled her, whatever the hell, I don't know. And the point is that George fucked up. So we now are going to go and hunt down FK. And yeah, Isaac and Isaiah. So let's get in the car.
And today we're stuck here having to search for lost
children. Well, they're not actually lost.
We're the ones who are lost.
Thank you, Emily.
So we are, Emily. Zach, we may as well have fun if we're getting lost.
York, no.
You sure know how to take your time in a time like this.
York, please. Okay. Okay, this way? Oh, shit. Sorry. Excuse me. Yeah, I'm just gonna stop in the middle of the road and check the map here real quick. Alright, so, it's off this way. Okay, so should I theoretically... Oh my god. Nope, not that way. Harry's mansion. Okay, good to know. Alright, that's where I need to go. Well, now where the hell am I? I am, right here. Alright, so if I go down Tree Street, actually I need to turn around. Tree Street to October Street, and then all of this. And, okay, alright, got it. So, yeah, let's just, turn around. Sorry.
I can't believe two people have been murdered in our town.
Oh, believe it.
And now two young children are at the center of it all.
Well,
I just can't come to grips with it yet.
Crime will happen wherever there are people.
True dat.
And that's why we have our jobs.
Might be easier for you because you don't live here. These were people that I knew that were killed. And the murderer might be someone who lives here in this town. It's really depressing.
I know. But someone has to bring this murder to justice.
You're right, I know. But, oh, Agent York, sometimes I just think I'm not really cut out to be a cop.
Oh, sure you are. You're fine.
Not true, Emily. You have the potential to be a superb law enforcer. You can be emotional at times, but you also possess what's most important.
What's that?
I do? What do you mean?
What do you think? A sense of justice.
Yeah. Justice? Well, yeah.
I must admit, I'm surprised to hear such a... How should I say this? Such an obvious answer. I thought you'd say something else.
Obvious or not, I joined the FBI in order to do what's right. And that's
what's important.
I understand, but still, you seem...
Spit it out, Emily.
I'm sorry. I need some time to
think. Aw, come on.
Whatever do you want to think about?
Justice. I want to think about justice.
Zach, she's quite the philosopher, isn't she?
Yes, she is.
Then again, death makes everyone a philosopher.
Okay, I think... This is, oh, hell. I am going the right way, right? Okay. In the car. Oh, hell. Okay, yeah, I'm fine. I really wish the map would not, spin. Okay, so get up here and then take a right. Alright. We're good. Alright, buddy, get comfy. I've got a cat in my lap. He's fidgeting a little. He had to go to the vet Saturday for his shots and his checkup. I put him in the carrier and he cried all the way to the vet. We got to the vet, sat in the waiting room, and he cried in the waiting room, and then after a while he kind of started to chill out a little bit and started purring. And then we got in the exam room and the vet came in and let him out of the carrier, and he just kind of moseyed out, making biscuits, purring, putting on a big show. The vet and the vet tech were both picking him up, cuddling him, and he was just being the sweetest little guy. Oh shit, I think I'm supposed to turn here. Yeah, here we go. And yeah, just putting on this huge, ham-tastic show. See, all the ladies at the vet love my one-eyed cat. He is a charming little man. Yes, he is. So, yeah. That was my weekend. How was yours? How was your weekend? How was your week? Oh, crap. Sorry, Emily. Sorry.
I'm thinking. Can you give me some space? Don't worry, I can look for the twins at the same time.
Okay. It's cool. All right, here we go. Fortunately, we have plenty of time to get there. Burm, burm. Oh, crap. Burm, burm, burm. Extra for long distance. Yay, thank you. Alright, we're almost there. Almost there. Little hairpin turn. Oh, hysterical marker. Another little hairpin turn. Shit. Sorry, Emily. Sorry. I am such a terrible driver. Hey, there's a card there. Hey, I think I passed. No, I didn't. I didn't pass it. It's right here. Well, where's the shiny thing? There's the shiny thing. There's a card. Yay, we're here.
According to Lily, Isaac and Isaiah should be here.
Yeah.
Then let's go and find them.
Well, that wasn't too hard. And they're chilling with Willie, and
hello,
he's got
Ben,
that
Isaac and
friggin'
Isaiah.
Sapling with him.
I hear you're teaching Willie to do tricks. What's your secret?
It's easy.
Uh-huh.
Really simple.
Uh-huh.
If he does it right, we give him a treat.
A cookie if he does it right.
Uh-huh.
I see. Very clever.
Positive reinforcement.
So, tell me, you two. Could you perhaps tell me your other special secret with Becky?
Ah.
No, we can't. It won't be a secret if we tell.
You can't argue with that.
I'm not telling. We promised Becky.
Now that's a problem. Because I also made a promise to Becky. A promise to catch the bad man word. But I can't keep my promise if I don't know what the secret is.
Uh-huh.
Do you see?
Okay. Whisper, whisper.
She told us to give Diane a box. It wasn't that heavy.
We took it to the art gallery and gave it to Diane.
Is that all Becky gave you?
Just when we were leaving to take the box to Diane, Becky called us back.
Yeah.
She handed us something. It was small and round. She told us to keep it safe in our pocket and give it to Diane.
Uh-huh. The locket?
And then you met Carol on your way?
Yep. I took the round thing out of my pocket and we looked at it.
And then she talked to us.
We told her that we were on an errand for Becky. She said she'd do it for us.
But we told her no.
Okay.
Because Becky
good. Asked
us.
Good kids.
Not her. We promised Becky to do it ourselves.
Good for you.
So Becky did entrust the locket to them.
Mm-hmm.
And now Carol has it. Right, Kaysen?
Huh?
Huh?
You were in the room when Carol took the locket back from Diane. I saw you with Diane in the art gallery that day.
Uh-huh.
Well, yeah, I was there in the room. Oh, then Carol burst in all angry.
Uh-huh.
While Carol and Diane had their talk, I just sat there like a
frog. I'm sure you did.
Yeah, so Carol took the locket from Diane, but that has nothing to do with me, right?
Yes, I believe so. But from this instant, you are now a key witness in this case.
Oh, snap.
I'm afraid you can't leave town until you...
Oh, snap.
What? Can you do that?
Uh-huh.
This is all starting to sound a little like Alice in Wonderland.
Which makes you Humpty Dumpty.
Oh, no, you didn't. Oh!
Isaac and Isaiah.
Well, at least he's not Tweedledee or Tweedledum.
I think I'll be able to keep my promise with Becky, thanks to you two.
How is Becky?
She's...
Is she getting better?
No, no.
She'll come and help out at our store again, won't she?
No.
She'll come and play with
no.
us again.
Oh,
won't
God.
She?
Boys, about Becky.
That's right. Becky is almost totally better now. But I don't think she'll be able to come and see you. I was told by Becky to keep this a secret. But she's actually a goddess of the forest, just like Anna.
Thank
you,
Emily.
I think she's gonna be in the forest with Anna for a while.
Thank you, Emily.
Cool. We'll keep this a secret then, too.
Wow.
Yeah, you do that.
That's why Anna and Becky are such good friends.
Okay, Willie.
You're happy too, aren't you?
Zach, I hope Emily doesn't end up as a forest goddess too.
Yeah, that's a possibility.
Okay then, Zach.
Okay.
Let's go over what we found out recently about the case.
Okay, sure.
First, Diane, the art gallery. She was out drinking with Nick Cormack in a bar on the night.
Right.
Nick confirmed this, and so she has an alibi.
Right, and so does Nick,
but then.
Then
we have what Nick's wife, Olivia, told us.
According to Olivia, Nick and Diane not only went to the bar, but also went somewhere
they
else.
They went back to the gallery. Yes, yes,
you
I do.
Where that
I
was,
do.
Zach?
That was the art gallery.
That's right, the art gallery.
Before another pop quiz gallery, here.
Diane looked back towards Olivia.
Uh-huh.
Almost as
she
though
did.
She saw Olivia in the dark. Nick's behavior has also become more suspicious.
Yes,
by the day.
Indeed. Nick's kind of an asshole.
If Olivia is correct, then he is heavily involved in this case.
Uh-huh.
But we have no conclusive evidence of that at the moment.
Bummer.
The only thing we can say for sure
is that Nick is an asshole.
Is that Nick's whereabouts are unknown at the time of Becky's murder.
True dat.
He has no alibi for the crime. But that fact alone means nothing.
Uh-huh.
So who was it that called Thomas
that
to
would be Quint.
Becky's place? That's right. It was Quint.
Becky's boyfriend.
Becky's boyfriend.
Yep.
He went to her house and saw the tragedy.
Yep. And he
murder.
Is,
I'm embarrassed.
Messed up now.
Killer struck again while we were on the case. We found her bitten off tongue.
Oh.
A massive amount of red seeds that poured out with the blood. And an inverted peace symbol, like the one seen at the site of Anna's murder. From the similarities, one can deduce that Anna's killer killed
Becky. Well, duh.
We also found one other important piece of evidence in Becky's room.
That would be the diary.
Can you remember what that was, Zach?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Sketchbook, right?
That's right. We found a sketchbook in Becky's room.
She had apparently written a letter to her sister Diane.
Right, because everybody in this town is related, you
It
know.
Revealed that Becky took a locket from Anna's body at the crime scene.
Mm-hmm.
She also admitted to borrowing a pair of Diane's mm-hmm. stiletto heel shoes. So, Miss Stiletto Heels was Becky. There was something else at the end of the letter. It said that she handed the uh-huh. locket and stiletto heel shoes to someone.
Well, duh, we just talked to him, York. Come on. Come on, bro. Isaac and Isaiah.
That's right, Zach. And from what Isaac and Isaiah told us, Carol offered to take the items to Diane, but the twins refused.
Yeah.
They gave them to Diane themselves, as they had promised.
Yeah.
For some reason, Carol wanted the locket.
Okay, that's weird.
She ended up storming into the gallery to take it from Diane. And when Carol took the locket from Diane,
shit got real.
Casey just happened to be there. Is Casey involved in this? Or was he just there by coincidence?
Yeah.
I wonder what's so special about the locket, too. Why did Carol want it so badly? The questions are mounting. Come to think of it, Quint, the first witness, has no alibi for Becky's death.
Oh, yeah.
We checked the phone records, and his call definitely came from her house.
Yeah?
Is it possible he attacked
I don't know. Becky? He was awfully messed up. I don't think so.
But everyone is suspicious one
yeah,
way or another.
Yeah, I really don't think it
what
was Quint.
Do next,
Zach?
Okay, who's the most suspicious?
Nick. Motherfucking Nick.
No, I don't.
You
think
don't?
So,
are you serious?
He's certainly suspicious, but there is someone
Diane.
Else in the center of this.
It's Diane.
That's right.
Holy shit, it is.
Becky's sister and Carol's enemy, linked to both
you know,
and Casey.
Now that you mention it,
owner of the art gallery.
All those profiling flashbacks.
So that's next move.
That's the hairdo. That is the hairdo, right there. Ho snap. It's Diane. It's fucking Diane.
So, you want to find out everything there is to know about Diane?
That's right. There's just too many things that we don't know. First, we need more intel about the relationship between Nick and Diane.
Mm-hmm.
How?
Nick and Diane meet every night at the bar. Let's use that.
Let's do.
George, we'll need you to stake out the gallery.
What do you mean?
Huh?
Wait in the parking lot.
I'm sorry,
the
these are not complicated
Diane,
concepts here, George. You
if
know what a stakeout is. Come
bar,
on.
You let me know. Emily, you take the diner. Wait for Nick, and tail him to the bar, too. As with George, if he goes anywhere else, then you let me know.
Okay.
Okay.
Thomas, you keep a watch on them inside the bar.
Yes,
okay,
I will.
Okay, no, that's not necessary, Thomas.
I'll be waiting in the parking lot of the bar. Once Nick and Diane are together, I will follow them
oh,
wherever
great.
They go. What time do they usually show up, Thomas?
Around the same time. Usually between 22 and 2300.
Okay.
Then at that time we do it, boys and girls.
Mm-hmm. Alrighty then. Hey. Clear? Okay. Okay. Yay, money. Yes, I'd like to save. Okay.
Zach, we need to be at Carol's bar at 2200.
Yes, thank you, York.
Looks like we have some time
yeah,
to kill.
Yeah, we do. What time is it? Okay.
We can go to the diner and see how Nick and Olivia are doing.
We can do that. But I think we're not going to do that right this minute. I think what we're going to do right now is I'm going to save. Let's see. I can just walk from here, actually. It's a nice night, but I'm not going to get out through there. I'm going to find a place to save. And then we are going to call it a day. Oh, there's a phone right there. Okay, folks. Thank you for watching, and I will see you next time. Bye-bye.